All right, let's call the meeting to order. This meeting is being recorded. I would ask if there's anyone else recording this meeting in the audience. Seeing none, if you'd please join me for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge of allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Welcome, everyone. We will now move on to special recognitions.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. The TAMI Awards I had shared with you at the last meeting, that's the equivalent of awards that are given for musicals or movies, in fact. So for Seussical the Musical, as I shared with you, they were nominated for numerous ones. There was an actual awards ceremony on May 21st, and four awards were given to Auburn High. So I'd like to congratulate Renee Morin for receiving an award for Best Featured Actress, Katie Lasley for an award titled Not Your Average Chorus Member, and the crew also received TAMIs for Best Hair and Makeup and Best Set Design. So I want to congratulate all who were involved in that incredible performance. It really was extremely well done. Staying with the fine arts, our Auburn High Concert Band attended the Great East Music Festival recently, and they received the gold medal performance for that. They earned a score of 93 out of a possible 100, which is truly impressive, and I know that you join me in our pride at our students' tremendous work that continues to reach ever higher heights. And then finally, Dr. Susan Lopez, I want to recognize her. She has recently earned her doctorate. The dissertation was titled Evaluation of Teachers' Perceptions of the Massachusetts Educator Evaluation Process, a Quantitative Study. So congratulations to Dr. Lopez, who's hiding in the back.
And you have to a speech prepared, Ms. Lopez? No?
All right.
Thank you.
And that's all we have for special recognitions.
Correct.
We now move on to citizens' comments. Are there any citizens' comments this evening? No? Wayne, did you want to say something on the citizens' comments?
No, I'm going to wait.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, sorry.
All right, we now move on to the student representatives' report.
All right, so the year is coming to a close. Seniors' last day, or last week of school, really, was last week. Senior week is this week, so they've been on their field trips the past 2 days. Graduation is this Friday with a half day for the high school. All of our spring sports have been doing very well. We have about 10 track members going to states. And something else that I wanted to talk about was a joint effort between AP Physics teachers and AP Environmental Science teachers, and really the whole science department of Auburn High School, who coordinated with four or so teachers at SWIS to bring up classes of 10th, 12th graders, 11th graders, to go and talk to third grade classes about science subjects, so whether it be magnetism, electricity, things along those lines. And we did one session of that last Thursday. We're doing another session tomorrow. And very, very good response from the students and from the teachers as well. So.
Excellent. Well, thanks for doing that. You are a part of it, right?
I am, yes.
All right. Beautiful. And that's all you have for the student representative's report?
Yep.
What's up for the summer? I don't want to put you on the spot.
We have many camps going on this high school. We have, I know Auburn Youth Family Services has a lot of youth camps as well. But in terms of that, it's just summer work and making sure you get all your stuff done on time before you come back.
Excellent. Thank you very much. Any comments, questions? Seeing none.
Just thank you and have a good summer.
Thank you.
I would now seek approval of the minutes of May 18th.
I'll make a motion to approve the minutes of May 18th.
Is there a second?
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. It is a vote. We now move on to the superintendent's report.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. This evening is one that is much anticipated on an annual basis because we get to have lots of students and their families in attendance with their principals and teachers to share just a sampling of some of the community service learning projects that they engage in across the community and throughout the year. As I say each year, we are tremendously appreciative of the support that we receive from the Auburn community. And this is one way that our students and their teachers and administrators give back to them. So without further ado, I'm going to turn it over to Mr. Gagnon from Auburn Middle School, who's going to go first, and he will invite up students to join him.
Good evening. I have here Elise Whittemore, who is the president of our National Junior Honor Society, and she's going to do a presentation on our community service learning project that we partnered with the Rotary on Shelterbox. Elise.
This year, AMS has partnered with Shelterbox and the Auburn Rotary. Together, we have helped Shelterbox bring life-saving aid to families affected by disasters. I've personally helped through different donations. The students have made donations during lunch, too. Shelterbox raises money through different little fundraising projects we've done. We've had a dance co-sponsored. We've raised lots of money through that, and all proceeds have gone to the Shelterbox. The Unified Arts teachers have put together little simulations for us to be educated on the different things Shelterbox does. We've had partnerships with Student Council and NJHS. The Unified Arts teachers have put together these simulations, such as building a shelter and designing shelter and carrying water over obstacle courses. We put bags on our backs and went through an obstacle course in the gym, such as going through the rock wall and over balance beams and through tires to get that feeling. The student council president and I presented the $1,000 check for Shelterbox with the money we raised. We'd like to thank all those who've donated to Shelterbox and helped them out. Does anyone have any questions?
Questions, comments? No? Very nice, thank you.
Thank you.
This was a effort that we put forth as we went through the pancake breakfast. The Rotary Club had a display of an actual shelter box and its materials. So I made a phone call and partnered with them. They brought in the shelter during our lunches. We had them out there during our lunches for students to see. And as Elise had explained, our Unified Arts had a day of where they went through different stations where students got to experience building, they saw a movie on a drink of water that they had read on a book that they had read actually, but the movie portrayed it. It was a worthwhile project. We had cheerleaders coming in during lunch to lead a cheer for Shelterbox. And we had a lot of activity in the school. We raised $1,000, and we're looking forward to tracking our Shelterbox. The video that wasn't able to play on YouTube shows you that you actually get an email from them that'll tell you once your Shelterbox is deployed. And they're deployed throughout the world. We've had them deployed in the United States, all over the world. And once that happens, they say, be patient. They'll send you the email, and then you can track it through emails where your Shelterbox ended up. So it's a very worthwhile cause. Elise led the charge. Effie Photos, who isn't here tonight, wasn't able to make it. She's our president of our student council. So it was a combined effort by all the students in the middle school. So thank you very much.
Excellent
job.
Thank you.
So next I'd like to invite Mrs. Chamberlain, principal of the Bryn Mawr School, along with our students and teachers. Good evening, everyone. So while this won't display the breadth of things that we do at Bryn Mawr School related to community service learning, it's a couple of highlights from this school year. So Mrs. Schofield is a kindergarten teacher, and she's here with Amelia Bulgros-Manfield and Vasilios Efthymiadis. And Mrs. Torini is a second grade teacher at Bryn Mawr School, and she's here with Owen Morrow and Molly Grandazzo. I was going to call her Melissa, and I knew it was wrong. So we'll let kindergarten begin.
This year, we reached out to a local family who has two children that attend Bryn Mawr School. Their father is currently stationed in Afghanistan for 9 months in his second tour overseas. As a service learning project, we paid tribute to this local soldier by collecting some basic necessities that they would like at this point in the year.
In April, our whole school collected items to send to the soldiers that help protect our country. Families sent in toothpaste, mouthwash, drink mixes, candy, granola bars, and lots more. We had 6 full boxes that arrived to the soldiers before Memorial Day. We did this to thank them for their service, to let them know we care about them.
This was extra special because our friend's dad is in the military. We sent items to Mr. Candelaria's unit. The classes also made cards and wrote letters for the soldiers. We made funny pictures using our thumbprints to make the soldiers smile.
It was a joy to watch them sort the items. Some things I overheard were, they deserve this, I bet they will share because soldiers are good people, and I think this will make them so happy. Also, his son said, I bet he won't share the Doritos. We received a heartfelt card and pictures from the family after they had arrived.
Hi, thank you for having us here. During the school year with second grade, we spent a lot of time talking about being kind to each other, being kind on the playground, in the classroom, and we're trying to teach the children how to be thoughtful. So we started with a song, and it kind of developed from there. We decided that we wanted to present something to the parents that volunteered during the course of the year to show that we appreciate their kindness. So Owen and Molly are going to explain our process, how it developed. It was quite an interesting project.
You Rock Project by the second grade classes at Bryn Mawr School. Our project started with a song. The song was Humble and Kind by Tim McGraw. We practiced the song and then learned to sign the chorus. We decided to perform the song at the parent luncheon. We sang for 2 reasons. 1, to thank the volunteers. 2, to pay the kindness forward. We came up with the idea of painting rocks with kind words. Then we added a note to each rock. We gave them to the volunteers during the song. The note said,
send this message off into the world. Leave them on sidewalks, benches, bus stops, beaches, or porches for strangers to find. Or give them to a friend. It's up to you what you do with this little rock. Most of all, you know that they were hand-printed with love from us to you. We hope that the people of Auburn and the people of the world that might find one of these special rocks will be cheered up. Please accept this rock so you too can spread kindness.
We have a video of the song that they performed that you can see afterwards. We did sign a lot of the songs, so they spent a lot of time learning the different signs for the song. So please accept this. This is what we gave to the parents for luncheon.
Thank you.
Thanks.
You mean I guess present? Thank you so much.
Does anyone have any questions or comments for the children?
You guys did an excellent job presenting, and thank you for the lovely gifts. It seems like you guys had a very busy but very good year.
Anyone else? Wayne?
I would just like to say it's a great job. I don't know if you want to call it a job or fun or whatever you want to call it, but it's just proud to have our children do things the way they do in the schools today with this kind of stuff. And I just want to thank even the first ones. I was going to wait until the end before I congratulated them and said how good of a job they did with everything and the donations and all the help and everything you guys do. It's great to have this school committee meeting here and have you guys come up and address us. It just gives you a warm heart. I mean, it really does. And I want to thank you.
Thank you very much. Great job, guys.
Next will be Mrs. Stanek with her students and staff from the Packetchog School.
Good evening, everyone. Tonight I have Doreen Guitar, one of my second grade teachers with me, and Christine Jamay, one of my first grade teachers. We also have Samantha Jess, a second grader, Paul Vangos, a first grader, and Kendallin Davis, a kindergartner. And tonight they're going to speak specifically to the ones that the grade level projects were this year. I have to brag a little bit. We did make a TV debut this year. We had done a video to Taylor Swift's Shake It Off in a Shake It Off for ALS project as a school-wide video, and we had a lot of fun doing that. Mrs. Garrow was great, taught us the dance moves, and also we did a fall food drive for AYFS, which was one of the biggest food drives that they had ever received. And we also did write letters with Project Patriot to the soldiers overseas as well. So I'm going to pass it off to our teachers. Thank you.
Good evening. As mentioned earlier, my name is Doreen Guitar, and I'm a second grade teacher at Packetchog Elementary School. And with me is Ms. Jamay, first grade teacher. And it's my pleasure to introduce to you a second grade student, Samantha Jess, from Mrs. Lemire's class, and a kindergarten student, Kendallin Davis, from Mrs. Hagen's class. They are excited to tell you about our community service learning projects. After those two speakers speak, a first grader, Paul Vangos, from Mrs. Jamay's room, will tell you all about the first grade project.
The second graders and kindergarteners project was to make Packetchog Elementary School more beautiful in the front of our building. First, we needed to get donations for the garden supplies. Our classes joined together and we wrote letters to places like Home Depot and Walmart. They were nice enough to give us flowers to plant and some mulch.
We got to go outside and plant flowers and spread the mulch. Everybody had a job to do. It was fun. My favorite part of this project was when we planted the seeds. I think after doing this project, I think we all learned that flowers take time to grow. And it is very hard work. Now, our school is one of the most beautiful places in Auburn.
First grade project was the Gamma and Booker. These items were collected near the holidays and were then donated to a woman's shelter. After we gave the pajamas and the books to the shelf,
at school. It was really fun to be able to wear a pajama at school. I think that all the first graders learned that it is a good feeling to give to others.
And then finally, Mrs. Lopez from Swanson Road Intermediate School with the team from her school. Good evening, everyone. I have a team of students here for you. There are three big community service learning projects that we had conducted this year at Swanson Road. I'm going to ask Nicholas Gillette and Leah McDonald to introduce our fall community service learning project, and in the meantime, hopefully get the technology components for the next two up and ready for you.
My name is Leah McDonald, and we are here to talk to you about a community service learning project our school completed this fall. In class, we talked about the sacrifices our military members are making by being away from their families to keep us safe. We then asked the community for addresses of family members from Auburn and surrounding areas serving overseas and sent out care packages. We decided to ask students of Swanson Road Intermediate School to donate some of their Halloween candy, as well as make cards for troops and donate $1 each to cover shipping costs. As a school, we all collected $464 to ship care packages. We sent 29 boxes filled with candy and cards to overseas members of the Army, Navy, Coast Guard, Marines.
Oh my God. Hi, I'm Nicholas Gillette. Our school loved to receive the thank you notes from these troops describing how much our candy and words of encouragement meant to them. We enjoyed reading the cards as a class, seeing pictures of soldiers holding up our cards and candy boxes, and finding the different locations where they were stationed on a map. Our favorite item was a plaque and coin sent from Guantanamo Bay, Cuba. On the plaque, the Army captain told us that our letters were displayed in the hallways of the command post and were a huge boost to morale. He told us how difficult it was to be away from family at this time of year. This helped us to feel proud to have helped. Every time we see the plaque, it helps us to feel thankful for all we have.
This time, I'd like to bring to the microphone Alexandra Lomovitz and Brooke Castellano. They're going to describe the courtyard improvements and the farm to fork program at Swanson Road this year.
Hi, I'm Alex Lomovitz from Swanson Road Intermediate School. And me and my six friends, Brooke, Leah, Nick, me, and two other people, Gavin, Wallace, and Morgan Ryan, we have all started farm to fork at our school. We want to make a courtyard garden. You might wonder what adult would supervise and help us. We are sure that there are school teachers who would love to help. It's a double miracle because no matter the grade, almost every teacher in the school teaches science. Plants are a common part of everyone's life. Hi, my name is Brooke Castellano, and I am a fourth grader at Swanson Road Intermediate School. Ms. Connell was the first officer to help. She said, "I would love to help you guys with the garden. If I grew fruits and vegetables, then school lunches would have more healthy, nutritious, and fresh fruits." In addition to that, not only would teachers help us with the science, we as students would learn about science. Also, we'd learn the responsibility and teamwork. Now let's talk about the 5-2-1-0. Five stands for the five more fruits and veggies a day.
This will help us a lot. Also, the students would learn to make connections to plants and gardens. This could help a fun learning opportunity.
Our possible plans to get supplies. We could have fundraisers to raise money. In addition to money, people could donate shovels, seeds, baby plants, and flower pots. And if there is extra money left over, we are going to give it to our gym teacher, Mrs. Shane, so when she goes to South Africa, she can use the money to help people there. We're wondering if we could sell some or most of the crops to the teachers or other members of the Auburn community. It will be great for people who live near our school. Also, the money can go towards supplies and seeds to grow more crops. We could categorize the crops and sell them on a specific day. Selling herbs and bagels and oregano will help us in the coming year. Possible plants to add to our courtyard to make it better.
Do you want your courtyard to look like this? Or this? No, garden will not look the same because it will look even better.
Where's the pond coming from?
Yeah.
There have been multiple people that have come to our school to teach us how the crops have come. We've had three people come so far. There has been the Regional Environmental Council, Han Lam, a garden education fellow, and then we've had other ones come.
Farm-to-table chef Sean Dacey.
We've had Miss Connell, one of her friends. She does Let Us Be Local. Her name is Lynn Stromberg, and Alex will be reading a part of it.
Fourth graders eating raw, fresh turnips for a snack at school. You read that right. A group of fourth grade students at Swanson Road Intermediate School have a special guest this past Thursday. Lynn Stromberg of Let Us Be Local, a company that connects local food service businesses with locally sourced foods, visited Swiss and brought a basket of fresh vegetables with her. In addition to turnips, she brought carrots, orange, white, yellow, and even purple carrots. You'll be glad to read that these 8 and 9-year-olds scooped them all up.
The purpose of Stromberg's visit was the real point of today's stories. According to the Swiss principal, Suzanne Lopez, a couple of months back, a group of fourth graders asked for a meeting. They wanted to start growing vegetables in the courtyard, said Lopez. So they wrote me a letter requesting a meeting. There has been one surprise in our courtyard, which has been a family of feathery birds. And they flew away today, but Alex will be reading a little bit.
Surprisingly, we had some visitors in the courtyard. These birdies are growing up so fast. The first picture is from when the birds just hatched. The second picture is from this afternoon after we took the picture today. Look, the birds flew away.
Thank you very much. That was our fourth grade students who had written me and sent me a Google email one evening and sent me a PowerPoint requesting a meeting. So that's how it all got started. So I had to go visit them one day during recess, and they discussed their plans with me, presented a PowerPoint, and then proceeded to tell me how they were going to go about doing this and the support they had from the teachers. The next group of students that's coming up is with regards to the arboretum that has been found on the Swanson Road grounds. I would like to introduce Amma and Ralph.
An arboretum had...
This is the arboretum of Jane...
Sorry.
It's not you.
An arboretum had been planted by James L. Corville in the 1970s. With the death of James L. Corville, the arboretum fell. It was sadly forgotten by Auburn students and teachers.
When we began researching Mr. Corville's work, and we discovered that one of his students had drawn up a detailed map. We researched everywhere for the map until the earthly miracle occurred when the map was recovered.
We investigated the space to figure out which trees were still living and which trees had perished. A biologist, Mr. Doyle, joined us for an afternoon to help us identify the trees.
We were excited when our story was featured in a Telegram and Gazette last month. In the future, we are hoping to create an Arboretum app for visitors from the community. The Arboretum has become a home for the Swiss family.
The video clip you're about to see has to do with the Arboretum, but it's student-made. It was put together with a bunch of different clips from students that have gone out over the course of the past month. And that's the end of our presentation. We're hoping to create some apps and some placards in front of the trees. So this is an ongoing project. All of our students are involved in that. As you've seen, there's a lot of nature that's involved at the beautiful surroundings at Swanson Road. But we've been very busy this year. And I'd like to thank the students and take any questions if anyone needs, or we can turn the mic over.
Any questions, comments?
Comment. Great job, guys. I saw my daughter out there too. This is a whole school project, basically. I know the third graders were out there doing stuff as well. So
every class has been involved in all of the projects that you've heard this evening. A lot of it brought the reading components in as well to prepare for comparative texts for our state testing as we prepared. But this has involved every grade level at every aspect of the school.
Yeah, and every subject, it seems like. Yeah, it's great. Good job. And kudos to the staff who made all this happen.
So. Special thanks to Mrs. Burbank and Ms. Cannell, who also tried to put the students together and organize everyone.
Great.
Any other questions, comments? Any comments as far as all the presentations go as we wrap this up? Gail?
I just, watching the children, the students, explain all the things they've done, I reflected back to last week when Auburn was in the news for an entire week, every day, because of the tragedy that had happened. And everyone that they interviewed said Auburn is a caring community. We all care about one another, and I think it showed from the youngest children here all the way up that we just care about everybody. And wherever we can reach, we try to help. And I think that's a beautiful thing that Auburn can take credit for.
I was thinking the same thing, Gail. With what we went through last week, it's great to see the community come together. We have a fantastic community. And then when nice things like this happen, it's great to see the community come together. As far as our future in Auburn here, with the teachers that we have and these wonderful students, I think our future is in really good hands, and I'm so proud to be a part of this community. And your presentations were great tonight. It was great seeing you all, and you should be very proud of yourselves. Wayne, did you have something?
I would just like to basically agree with what Gail had said. And the thing is, what these children are doing and students are doing, they're sending out letters and stuff like that to servicemen that really need these kind of programs to, what they deal with on a day-to-day basis. And you children make some kind of ease to them by sending these letters of love and support that you do. And I hope you keep it up for year after year. And if there's anything we can do as a school committee, you let us know and we'll support it. We'll help you in any way we possibly can. And it's a good educational thing for our school children, young and coming up. The more stuff you do when they're younger, they remember as they grow older and they become very great people. And I just want to say your dedication with the teams, the principals, the teachers, you ought to feel proud of what you do with your kids. Thank you.
Before we bid you good night, could we just have all the students and teachers that took part in this community project just come up to the front so we can give you one big round of applause before you head out for the night? I think we missed a couple of you. I want to make sure that we've got everyone.
Come to me to his middle and squish together a little bit so we can get a picture.
Yeah. We have everyone. Excellent work. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Couple more seconds. Keep smiling. We got everyone.
They look so nice. They're all dressed up.
Couple more over there in the corner. Thank you. Like to entertain a motion for a brief recess while we check out some of their work say goodbye to them. All in favor?
Aye.
Like to call the meeting back to order. And we move back to the superintendent's report.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Thank you for all your kind words to the students and teachers and administrators. It really, truly is a sampling, but as Mrs. Coffin and I were saying when we spoke, it's really uplifting to hear such as some of the good things that the kids are doing, which is great. The next item is, as we typically do, we bring forward to you out-of-state field trips that are planned for next school year. Several of these are ones, in fact, I believe all of them are ones that have taken place before, other than the Auburn Middle School's trip to the 9/11 Memorial down in New York City. I would also draw your attention to the Auburn High Band field trip. I believe it changes location annually. They have gone in the past. This one would be to Toronto, Niagara Falls, and Cleveland's Music in the Park at Cedar Point.
I would, if there's no issue, I would entertain a motion to approve all of the field trips. Has everyone had an opportunity to look over the applications?
I would like to discuss the trip to France. I have no problem with the other trips.
Okay. Well, how about we I entertain a motion to approve all of the field trips that we've had a chance to look at, except for the France trip, and then we'll work on that one?
Yeah. I'll make that motion.
We have that motion. Is there a second?
Second.
Any discussion on the other trips? Seeing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. It is a vote. And would you like to discuss the France trip? Go ahead, Gail.
Since I retired, I've traveled everywhere that I could go. And one of the places I wanted to go, but I haven't been able to go, was France. And I had planned to go to France this summer. But after all the terrorism and the things that have happened, we postponed the France trip. Maybe for another year, hopefully, but it's kind of a watchful wait. And I've been monitoring the U.S. government travel guidelines on their website, travel.state.gov. And they have a European travel alert that was actually posted yesterday. And they've been ongoing. And they're alerting U.S. citizens to the risk of potential terrorist attack throughout Europe, targeting major events, tourist sites, restaurants, commercial centers, and transportation. And this current travel alert that they just posted expires August 31st, 2016. France is hosting a large soccer championship June 10th, July 10th. And this goes on to say that France has extended its state of emergency, which they've been under ever since the terrorist attacks, through the end of July. So I would like to maybe postpone approving the trip to France at this time until we can maybe get a more favorable travel alert that, you know, our government thinks it's all right to go there now and it's not on a, you have to be cautious, you know, be extra careful. I just don't want to send our students into danger. And we all know that American children having a good time are going to stand up. Because, I mean, I've been to trips over to Europe and they say, well, don't dress like an American, don't wear your red, white, and blue, and tone it down. Well, our children are going to be Americans, and you expect them to have the joy that children would have traveling. But I don't want to send them into danger. I'd like to maybe think about this a little bit or postpone the decision for a while. Or certainly, if things clear up over there, I mean, in many regards, I think Europe might be safer now than it ever was because they're all on alert, but they did just blow up a plane out of Paris, so I don't know. I'm concerned about this.
Well, my concerns would be, and I don't know much about it, I understand what you're saying. It's I hate to think about it, but I do understand what you're saying, and it's a terrible situation. I don't know if the teachers or whoever the chaperones are that are going to be on this trip have purchased the insurance for the trip, where maybe they could back out at the last minute should something come up sometime next year. My concern is all the planning that goes into a trip like this. I would rather approve and then have them cancel the trip based on parent input and based on the input of the teachers and based on whatever information that we're getting from the government at that point in time. So I don't think any of us want to see anything bad happen, but I have to believe that also the parents and the teachers and the leadership teams of Auburn would not allow the trip to happen if it's something that they could cancel at the last minute. So I'd like to get more information based on that. That being said, I don't know if this is something that we could put off for another meeting, or if you have any information as far as the trip insurance goes and when they could cancel. And I'm just thinking that based on everything that goes around the world as far as terrorism goes, unfortunately, we never know where it's going to strike next. It could be right in Boston again. But we need to leave these decisions in the hands of the parents who are allowing the students to go on the trips, as well as the teachers that are planning the trips. I don't think we have, I don't want to say we don't have the authority to tell them they can't do it. We certainly could disapprove of the trip, but I don't know that that's the route that we want to go. I think we should probably wait and see how things go. Wayne?
I would agree with Gail at this time, because, you know, I don't care how much planning or whatever they did already, that doesn't support it for me when you may possibly lose a kid. Planning means nothing. Children do, in my opinion. And if there's a time or an insurance issue, like you're saying, I would like to withhold this until next month, until we find more about the insurance. And I don't want to be the one to put any students in harm's way. I don't care what it is. You know, you say it's not our really our responsibility, it's up to the parents. But you think if they went out there and they had a problem, we wouldn't feel bad about it? We would all on this board, whether we agree or disagree with each other, would not feel, would be very, very hurt. And I'd just like to get some more information so we can really look into this. And Gail, I want to thank you very much for looking that up and finding this out, because I had nothing knowledge of that at all. But I want to thank you for doing that, and I would like to make a motion to hold this until next meeting.
I would just like to say that, you know, I appreciate Gail's comments as well, and the research that goes into it, and you keep an eye on things over there. But as far as us feeling guilty if something happens, of course there's going to be some guilt involved. But as I look down this list of field trips that we just approved with the snap of a finger, New York City, Hyde Park, New York, Quebec, Canada, Washington, you know, I don't see much of a difference here other than the high alert that's taking place right now. We don't know what type of alert there's going to be when the time for the trip comes. So, you know, I don't know. If we want to live in fear, we can do that. But I choose not to, and I think many parents choose not to because they don't want to raise their children that way. Wayne?
I'm not saying that you have to do it in every field trip you're talking about. This is one hot area, as of right now. Why should we do it?
In 25.
I mean, why can't we postpone it until another time? And you can't tell me because of the planning, because I just don't buy that. A child is worth a lot more than a plan, in my personal opinion. At this point, if you voted on it tonight, I would not approve it. And you need to take things case by case. You know, and this is definitely a bad area at this point in time. Maybe it'll lax up in a few months or something like that, or the insurance will come out, or whatever. If they can drop it at a moment's notice, saying no, we're not going to go, well, that's fine. But that just brings up everything else. I'm sorry, but until I get further information, I will not vote for this.
Chair, might it be prudent to actually, if we need to go through and approve these, actually, one by one, we should really be looking at all of these as it gets closer to time. I have family that lives in Europe. My sister works for the Department of Defense. We don't really know now what's gonna be like in a year. So I would actually think it might be better just from a cost perspective, and you know, so that we don't lose time to approve it. With the caveat that we would expect some sort of a report closer to time for really any of these trips, if they think that there's an issue. You know, you're right, even New York City, D.C., you know, we don't know what it's going to be like in a year from now. So, but could we maybe just respectfully request that each of the faculty members that are going through this, maybe a month in advance, just let us know the status for how they feel? Would that be a good compromise?
I think we could certainly revisit that at the same time. I think that if there's a code red or however the alert process works in New York City, when it comes time for the New York City trip, right, I'm thinking a few people are going to be bailing out of that trip. If the same thing happens in Hyde Park, there's a situation in Hyde Park where there's a red alert. I'm thinking whether they get the insurance back for the trip, they're able to get that reimbursement, I think they're just going to cancel the trip. That's my opinion. I know that I would certainly keep my child from going. But as I said before, no, it's certainly not going to hurt to get that feedback as these trips approach.
Right, and through the chair, I think where I was coming from is also just to make sure that it's public, that we know, you know, that the parents of any kids know that, you know, we've taken the time to look at closer to time too. So just
Well, like a grand deal for that.
Well, well said. Any other comments?
Just have a comment. I mean, thank you, Gail, for doing the research as well. And I agree that we should see if there is an insurance policy. But we have to be careful where we're not telling parents what they can and can't do. Like, the parents are the ones that are sending these kids. We're not sending them. The teachers aren't. So I agree. If it's under a state of emergency, then we definitely need to consider at a later time when it gets closer if it's safe or not. But I agree with George, where New York City is also a melting pot of activity. And so we just need to be careful what we're telling parents they can and can't do and sending their kids.
I think Wayne's hand was up first, Gail.
Do you have any knowledge of New York City? Do you have any information or anything on it? You're saying that it is, but do you have any numbers or do you have any warnings or anything?
Do you have a pamphlet or a brochure?
I
think history can...
I'm worried about my kids in the school department. And whether you like it or you don't like me, that's too bad.
Thanks, Wayne.
I'm supporting them, not you.
Thank you.
You're welcome. And...
if Jess had any evidence.
Right, that's fine, as far as that goes. But the thing is, and your other mistake was, I feel, is that when you said it's up to the parents and everything else, it's up to the parents to a point. We are the ones that vote to approve or disapprove. It's not the parents. I just want to make that clear.
Gail?
And if I could go on that, I just think, as a parent, if my child told me the school was bringing this amount of teachers and these children and everyone else was going, they're not worried, Mom. Why are you worried? It's almost like you get pushed into agreeing to send your child. Obviously, the parent that maybe is as cautious as I am would say no right from the start. But there's others that might say, everyone else is going, it'll be okay. And I'd like to see it be okay. But to me, as long as France is declaring itself, it has a state of emergency, and our own government is giving a travel alert, these things need to be, to my eyes, cleared up before we say, yeah, it's okay to take our kids. I just...
Wayne?
We're not saying no to the trip, per se. What we're saying no is to hold it off at this time because of the major, major alerts out in France.
Yeah.
Very serious. People are getting blown up. And as Gail had said, at this point, I wouldn't support it because I would not want a parent or something happening out there and a parent, and I don't know how to really put this because it gets very touchy, if they lost somebody. I probably couldn't take it.
Mary Ellen?
Through the chair, if I could offer this as a suggestion, and first, for a little bit of the background on why we, because it wasn't always the case that we brought forward all of the out-of-state field trips, but we made that decision several years ago because there really was the desire, and I agree with it, on the committee's part, to have at least 3 months advance notice. The committee at the time, and some of you may have been a part of that, didn't want teachers going forward and starting planning and telling kids about a trip before it was actually approved by the school committee. So we had actually decided, let's put them all together in the spring of the previous year. So having said that, it sounds like there's interest from the committee for me to get some information. I don't know how far in advance for this France trip, and this is one, and I appreciate that there's a warning that I honestly was not aware of myself either, but that to find out when they would need this, you've got another meeting on June 29th, I could come back with some more information. To the point that Mrs. Kaufman made, you know, for these out-of-state trips, I will say that we certainly would watch and see, you know, if there was a warning that came up in any part of the country where we were going to be sending our students, to obviously consider that decision, and would none of us here, or teachers, or any of us, would ever want to knowingly send students into harm's way. So perhaps we could look at, you know, doing some sort of a check-in that I could certainly oversee with the principals to be sure that before they go to New York or wherever, because the reality of it is, the world in which we live, none of us can say it doesn't happen here anymore, unfortunately, as much as we wish that were the case. So we could certainly do that. That would be stuff that we would do internally. I would be happy to report that if you want, but I'm also happy to come back with more information on the France trip. I believe there's time for planning, but I've not spoken with her. I don't know.
Well, why don't we push this vote off until we get more information regarding the France trip. As far as the logistics, the scheduling, the insurance policy, what the opt-out is to be reimbursed for the insurance policy. If the opt-out is something where there is a red alert of some sort, then you can get out of it.
Mm-hmm.
That's fantastic, and we don't have to worry about this.
Cool.
So why don't we put that off?
Okay.
I made a motion to put on hold until next meeting.
Do I have a second?
I'm going to ask that we postpone until the first meeting in July, because I'm not going to be here.
Oh.
For the last meeting in June, because you've moved it back and I'm going to be away now that week.
I don't know that we have time for
I'd have,
it off
yeah.
that far. That's kind of defeating the purpose of us putting it up and getting the information.
July 27th.
Oh, it's all the way in July?
Put it off until the next meeting and revisit it then.
Okay.
Yeah.
You will be at the next, you won't be at the next meeting?
Yeah, that's what you said, no.
Because it was going to be the 22nd or something, but because of the trips coming back from, yeah, I would have made that one, but I'm not going to make that last one. That's been moved to the end of June.
And your suggestion is what, Dr. Renaud?
I would really need to check with Ms. Fidella that she's planning the trip. I don't know the timeline of what would be required. What you may want to do is we can put it on for the 29th. If there's lead time still available, we could put it on. You could just postpone it on the 29th and put it to the 27th. But until I speak with her, I just don't feel comfortable.
Sure.
I don't know what's required, but I guess I would ask through the chair that if she does need approval on the 29th, that it be considered at that time on the June 29th, and if she doesn't, then move it to the 27th.
Because I'm thinking about my own trip. I canceled it 2 months before we were supposed to go without any problem.
Okay.
Because they had travel insurance.
Mm-hmm.
So hopefully they have something comparable.
If we need to reconvene somewhere in between, we could possibly do that too. If it means not shutting them out of the field trip and allowing them to plan properly, then we could probably get the five of us together at some point, I would think. I know it's not easy, but I think we could probably come up with 10 or 15 minutes here or there. So,
what is the motion?
Do I have a second?
Right.
Do I have a second?
But we may. Well, the thing is, we may have to leave it up in the air because you may switch. You know, if Gail can't make the 29th, we may do it on the 26th or whatever.
Mm.
You know? I don't know where we should go with this or just leave it open air for now.
If I could suggest that we postpone, through the chair, I apologize, that we postpone until an upcoming meeting, and then after I speak with her, we can determine if June 29th works or July 27th, or if neither does, we can try to get pulled together a meeting, as Mr. Scobie said.
Okay, I'll change my motion to that.
Second. Any further discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
There's a vote.
The next item also comes before you annually is the updates to the student handbooks. And as you can see, by and large, most of them reflect date changes, lunch price changes that you had previously approved, obviously current staffing, which would be done. And it is my recommendation that you approve those as submitted.
would entertain that motion.
I'll make that motion that we approve the handbook updates and changes as submitted to us.
Is there a second?
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye. It's a vote.
It's already at that time of year where we are looking to announce our retirees as listed here in your packets. We did put together, at your request, a letter of thanks that we will pass around for each of you to sign to thank each of these members for their numerous years of dedicated service to the Auburn Public Schools. As we look to these individuals on an annual basis, and we've also got those, the hires that have been made to date, it is absolutely thousands, in fact, tens of thousands of children that these individuals have impacted in a really positive way. So those letters are there for you, and assuming, I should say, I'm making an assumption on the next action item, that you vote to actually do those and that we will take care of distributing them.
Okay, I would entertain the motion.
I make a motion that we sign letters to retirees.
Second.
Any comments?
I would just like to say thank you to all of them for all their time and service they've done for the Auburn District and all the children that they had brought up through their grades and taught and taught. And as you know and we know, as a school committee, the teachers and principals have done an amazing job at what they're doing with our children. And I applaud them and the retirees.
And I wish them happy travels.
Excellent. May they enjoy a wonderful retirement.
Yes.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. It is a vote.
Thank you. And then finally, item in my report is, as you know, the Worcester Youth Orchestras has actually been using our facility here at Auburn High School, this just completing their second year based on approval that you had given them a couple of years ago. They are looking to make some changes to that. Currently, they have their practices on Saturday mornings from 9 to noon. What they're finding, though, and as I've reported with you before, AP study sessions are on Saturday mornings, SATs. Students are just busier and busier. So they're requesting to change from Saturday until Sunday. They're also asking to add a Tuesday evening from 6 to 8 p.m., and that would be to have a wind ensemble group that would be open to Auburn students, but those across the local area as well. So what I have proposed before you for your consideration is, by moving to Sunday, we would need to charge the custodial fee because we may need to bring in for overtime charges there. But just as you have done with another organization, is to waive the site manager fee, but in return for that, to open it up to 12 Auburn students that could participate as part of the WYO free of charge. Now, the original agreement was 5 students could participate. They did so. And then also another thing that they did through Mr. Bernard with Miss Bailey here, they took students to, I believe it was WPI, for a festival of music. So that was something else, and they paid the fee for them to go. It's absolutely benefiting our students. So that would save 12 students $685 for a total value of $8,220. There would be the flat fee to rent the auditorium, which would be at a reduced rate from what you've had, but it still brings in some revenue for that maintenance piece, which I know is important to us all. In terms of the wind ensemble, from 6 to 8, again, to in lieu, if you approve, of a site manager to allow any and all Auburn students who wanted to participate. And this is even more so important because we don't have this offering available to our students right now. I've spoken to one of the band instructors and believes this is a tremendous value. So really couldn't put a value on it other than it will save each family $685 who wants to participate in this, something that we can't offer. So what you would also say, and we would provide training on site manager, and with the understanding that if any issues arise, if there's any maintenance or any fooling around that goes on or any damage at all, that we could immediately reinstate having our own site manager there, that they would pay. And the idea, which was a great one that you had put in place back a couple of years ago, and it's actually a November holiday concert, I forgot to change that, they're doing a
both a winter and spring concert, and that what they would do is they don't charge people to go. I think some of you have attended, but they collect donations, and that 50% of any donations made would actually be donated to Auburn Youth and Family Services to then give back to even more people in our community.
Excellent. I would entertain a motion.
I'll make that motion to approve the fee structure for WYO as presented.
Do I have a second?
Second.
Any discussion on that?
Through the chair, I just want to say that I was lucky enough to attend the holiday concert, and I was blown away. So any chance that anything we can do to further support this organization, I can only imagine it's an unparalleled experience for those kids. I mean, you just can't replicate that in a lot of the towns around us. So thank you for even bringing this to us. I can say I'll wholeheartedly support this.
Wayne?
Yes, I have gone to one too, and it was amazing. I never walked in that door expecting to hear the way it was when I went in there. It was just unbelievable, and I will support them anytime they need us for help or support. I will always be in favor of it, and I want to thank you.
It is a great organization, and for our students to be able to take advantage at no cost, at least up to that number, and who knows, that number could change if they're happy with the arrangement, and we're happy with the arrangement, who knows, you know, what's in store. And then the unlimited amount of time that our students will get on Tuesday evenings for the wind ensemble, and hopefully at some point graduating to the big show, which I also attended last year. That was just they are phenomenal musicians, and it's a well-run organization. So if there's nothing that you think we need to go over on that, Dr. Vanell?
I really feel very comfortable, and actually I want to thank Mr. Hopper. Bruce Hopper actually brought this forward to myself and then to the school committee. I think it's a really win-win situation. I think that they get the use of a beautiful facility, but our students get the benefit of an experience that we otherwise could not provide for them.
Yeah. I will say I entertained a phone call from Bruce Hopper. It's been a couple of years now since he called. He probably called everyone on the board at that point in time. I wasn't quite sure what we were getting into. I've seen some school bands before, and wow, I had no idea how fantastic they were going to be. Wayne?
I would just like to recommend it to anybody, whether you got children in it or not. I mean, just to go to see this will definitely be unbelievable. Go if you can.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye. There's a vote.
Thank you.
And we now move on to unfinished business.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. The Auburn Middle School project, while we anticipate closing it out in the not-too-distant future, there are a few remaining items that are being addressed. We have two appointments from the School Building Committee, Mr. Lon Bowden and Chairperson Mark Imsey, whose terms expire June 30th. So it is my recommendation that you reappoint them to those positions. It would be for a 3-year term, but I would anticipate that once everything is signed off on and audited, it may disband.
I'll make that motion.
Do I have a second?
Second.
Any discussion? I'd just like to thank them for this service. Much appreciated. And everyone on the School Building Committee. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Ms. Pope.
The next item, we received great news from Jess Delaconio of the Mass School Building Authority just last week, that at their Board of Directors meeting of May 25th, that they did approve the accelerated repair replacement of the Packachog roof, which means at this point that we've been invited and to enter into the feasibility study phase. And if you remember from the last time we went through this, that we would now hire, MSBA would assign us an OPM, an owner's project manager, and we would begin the process of actually analyzing the roof and designing what it would take to actually get it completed. There is a requirement, and I want to make you aware, just as we did last time, that I will need to submit a letter to the executive director, Mr. Jack McCarthy, to let him know where the funds will come from to support the actual feasibility study, which we're estimating to cost approximately $30,000, somewhere in that vicinity, based on an analysis of what the Bryn Mawr project and the middle school project. I need to submit that to them by June 29th, which is the date of our next meeting. So I want you to know that I will share that a copy of you of that with you via email and talk about it that evening. But other than that, this is very exciting news, and Mr. Scobie and myself, as well as Julie Jacobson, who was already signed as Chief Executive Officer, do need to sign on this. And typically what I'd ask is for you to take a vote in support of this for Mr. Scobie to sign on behalf of the school committee.
I would entertain that motion.
I'll make that motion.
Is there a second?
Second.
Any discussion? I would just like to say MSBA has been unbelievable to us.
Right.
I can't believe that they're coming back again with more funding, or the possibility of more funding, and that the town supports these endeavors as well. So it's just, it's great for our schools. So thanks to them.
Mm.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye. There's a vote.
I oppose.
Oh.
And the reason is not because of school buildings committee, it's because of issues that I had with the chairman. And I'll leave it at that.
Oh, sorry.
The next item, I updated you at the school committee meeting that followed the public hearing, that Dr. Lozay and I had had several meetings with Dr. Crystal Zhang, who is a resident of Auburn, has a child who attends our schools, and she is a part of a organization called Entry America Strategies, LLC. And getting your enthusiasm at that meeting on April 6th, our conversations have continued, and most recently in our meeting with her, and first we invited Mr. Hanfield and then invited Mr. Gaggin and Mrs. Lopez to this as well. If you remember, the idea with this would be for us to accept students, and they would handle, the company would handle finding host families and all of that. But students from China would come over and spend 4 weeks in our schools, and this is the proposal that she has given to us, that we would actually receive $800 per student for their participation here. That would include their bus transportation, if there were school activities that would take place. Parents would be responsible, the company would be responsible to find host families. If they were young students, they would come with a parent or a chaperone. Mrs. Zhang, Dr. Zhang, or others within their organization would serve for oversight of this. But we believe that this really has a great potential to benefit not only the students coming from China, but certainly the students here in our schools by welcoming them. So it really, we see it as, eventually maybe it would be great to have a program where we send students over there for a longer period of time. Hopefully this will lead to us having real serious discussions about bringing a Mandarin program here to our schools. But we see it as a great first step, and I seek your approval for us to continue finalizing the details and hopefully get this off the ground for the next upcoming school year.
I would entertain that motion.
I make a motion to approve the APS entering into a contract Entry America Strategies LLC and move forward with the planning with this exchange program.
You have a second?
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
There's a vote.
Thank you. That's wonderful news. We will keep you updated as more develops on it. So thank you.
We now move on to new business.
Thank you. So the first item under new business is the school committee proposed dates for next school year. These are really very much in keeping with the dates that we have had typically done. And one to point out to you, when we were more thoughtful in this. This is senior week, and the high school is just a flurry of activity. As you probably heard the applause, it was senior awards night. So we did check to see that June 7th is actually after graduation next year. So it is my recommendation that you approve these dates.
I would entertain that motion.
I'll make the motion to approve the dates listed for next year.
Is there a second?
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye.
And then in terms of upcoming events, our students had an incredibly successful trip to Washington, D.C. They actually returned home just this past Friday evening. The Memorial Day programs
were absolutely outstanding and just such fitting tributes. We had veterans, some of the very same ones that traveled, particularly on Thursday the 26th, from Packachog to the middle school program to Bryn Mawr School, and then returned, many of them and even some additional ones, to the next day. I actually think Bryn Mawr may have been on Friday, unless I'm misremembering, but I did get to them, and they were outstanding programs. Actually, it was Swanson, that's right, on Friday. As you know, unfortunately, the Memorial Day program in town was canceled, but there were lots of parents at our school-based programs. Last night, they had the grade 5, actually the grade 6 students, current 5th grade parents. Students will go to grade 6, had a great orientation program at the middle school. There are ones upcoming for entering 3rd grade, spree days, award ceremonies, graduations upcoming with high school on Friday. So, lots of good things happening.
Excuse me, what time on Friday are you supposed to be there?
It's a 6:30 start. It will start at 6:30, but with parking being what it is, I would encourage you to get here early. Because it fills up quickly.
Yeah. Well, you know, I could leave my car here tonight.
There you go, and I'll pick you up on the way.
There you go. Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
We now move on to teaching. Oh, Wayne?
I have a couple of things I'd like to bring up. I was going to bring them up in the beginning, but I didn't want to get involved with it with the children and everything else. First, I would like to request a moment of silence for the police officer and chief of police in Auburn that had passed away recently.
Chief of firefighters?
Yes. Chief of firefighters.
Yeah, Roger Buckley.
Yep. And I'd like to get a moment of silence for those two.
Absolutely. If we could just bow our heads for a moment. Thank you, Wayne, for that. We've lost a couple of great individuals, and they'll be sorely missed.
And I would like to thank both of them for their service at the town.
Yes.
On another issue, I would like to thank the townspeople, numerous townspeople, sending cards, fruit baskets, flowers, plants, and everything. When my brother had passed away a week and a half ago, it just shows how people really care when they're in the right place, and how they care about your family, and how they care about what you do and what you stand for. A lot of these people didn't even know my brother, but because they know the family, they went out and beyond to be kind. And I just want to thank them. I would thank Gail and Dottie for their condolences and their kind words from the school committee. But it's all of you people. I couldn't even send out letters to everybody. So I asked to make a comment tonight on behalf of that, because I just want to show people I care, and I want to thank you for doing what you do.
Well said. My condolences to your entire family.
Thank you.
We now move on to teaching and learning.
I thought I would start this evening by just highlighting some of the various programs that will take place over the summer for our educators as well as our students. So we have almost 100 teachers this summer working on curriculum throughout the summer. We have 3 days of ELA work, which will give teachers an opportunity to look at the new program, Wonders, which we have just adopted. They'll be able to really look at the components. I guess there's an enormous amount to choose from. So by grade level, they'll really articulate which pieces will be most appropriate to start with. They'll also look at some common assessments with that. We'll also spend 2 days or so working to look at Go Math again. We spent the first year implementing it, but there's some tweaking we want to do, so we'll work with teachers to do that.
There'll be a couple of days of science and social studies work. We have guidance people working. We have special educators working. We also have teachers doing some co-planning around co-teaching. So there's a lot of staff development and curriculum work going on. We have offering four different student summer programs this year, and they'll all be housed at the Auburn Middle School as opposed to the Auburn High School, where it has been held in the past few years. And one of the programs, as you know, is the extended year program, which is for our students on IEPs who qualify for an extended amount of time. That will run for 5 weeks, 4 days a week, 4 hours a day. We also offer the Title I program, which is for our lowest performing students across the district. That's grant funded, and that will only run for four weeks, but it will also be 4 days and have 3 hours each day of remedial math and reading. We also offer, and some of you might be familiar with the middle school program, a STEM camp. It's a one-week program. It runs 5 days a week, 8 to 3 for the day. The kids bring their lunch. It's kind of modeled after the WPI STEM summit program, and the kids seem to come back year after year, and enrollment grows every year. And this year, we're offering a new camp called Camp Invention. Some of you might have even heard from your students about it, that when they came home, or seen the flyer. It's really a National Inventors Hall of Fame program, so there's an outside vendor. However, they come in, we'll have them at the Auburn Middle School as well. It's a week-long program. It's geared for students entering first through sixth grade. It's all hands-on. If you get an opportunity to watch the video about it, you'll see how excited the kids are about it. We will hire our own staff to do this. Hopefully we will fill it, and if not, we'll be able to open it up to outside communities as well. And there's a fee for students to attend this that helps fund it.
Excuse me, did you say it's called Camp Invention?
Yes.
Oh!
It really looks engaging. I think that we're going to find that we love it and we're going to want it back every single year.
Yeah.
We originally saw it being offered in a nearby district, and they were recruiting our Auburn students, and we said, we're going to do our own. So that's what we're doing this year. We're really
Sounds
excited
good.
About it. Yeah, we're excited. Next in your packet, you'll find a memo outlining some surplus English language arts materials. As you know, we adopted a new series this year, Wonders. And we have old Houghton Mifflin materials. We have some old anthologies and some old student journals. We'd like your permission or your approval to allow our students to take them home and play school or whatever they do with it. And whatever's left over, we'd like to be able to donate. So that's something I'm requesting.
I would entertain that motion.
I'll make a motion to deem the prior ELA curriculum materials a surplus.
Is there a second? Any discussion?
I just want to bring up something that happened recently with surplus stuff that the school has been dealing with. I know I've talked to very, very many veteran groups, and the Tuttle Post have requested to get some chairs that they needed, really needed. And the school had came through and they gave them the chairs. And I just want to say I want to thank Mary Ellen and whoever else set up that to help out the veterans in the town of Auburn, by giving them the chairs where they didn't have to go out of their way to get chairs or go and buy them. Now they have chairs for functions anytime they need it. And I would like to thank you for that.
So I appreciate the thanks, but I just want to extend it to Mr. Fahey, and it's to all of you too that supported that. But I think it's great that we've been able to, through your support, to communicated with Stella D'Arcangelo from AYFS today, and she's thrilled at some furniture that she got. So we sent it out to all the nonprofits. We'll provide it at the next meeting, just a brief overview of how many organizations were able to take care of it. So it would be great. And I think sending these books home with kids is a win-win. They can play school, and hopefully they'll read them.
Yes, that's great.
It's nice that on this board we've got people that are so closely tied to the community and some of these organizations, whether it's the veterans or Auburn Youth and Family Services. Yeah. It's great that we have those ties. So when things like this come up, they're obviously going to get first dibs on it. Mm. So that's great. All in favor? Any other comments?
I have a question for Kathy, but it's not about it's about summer program as opposed to...
All right, well, we'll take the vote and then go right ahead. All in favor?
Aye.
Through the chair, I just had a question about moving the summer school program to the middle school. I know when they had it at the high school, the kids had an option to actually then go to the camp that was provided by the Youth Rec Center. Is there any kind of similar programming offered? I just know a lot of working parents that needed to have their kids in summer school were relying on that.
So the rec program will also be housed at the
Auburn
Middle School.
Oh, fantastic.
So we
have
everything going.
Okay, great. Thank you. Thanks for clearing that up.
So while I was at talking about the surplus ELA materials, I thought I'd give you a few highlights about where we are with the new adoption as well, just so that everybody out there knows how far we've moved along with that. So we've actually had our first professional development with that on May 10th. We had teacher manuals in hand, no other materials. The consultants came in from the publishing company. Teachers gave such positive feedback on the presentation and the overview. They're really excited about the program as well, so that was positive. One of the pieces that we find really good about this program is the technology. Some of you who have younger kids in the district know about GoMath and ThinkCentral and how there are sometimes some glitches. Well, this one, EdConnect, seems to be far more friendly. So we're looking forward to using that, and on August 30th, we'll have some professional development around that. And we hope in the early fall to be able to share that again with parents like we did at a PTO meeting for the math. We have 3 days in October already built into our schedule for the consultants to come and do building visits and talk to teachers and answer questions. And then we have a half a day in January that topic will be determined as teachers get to use the program and questions arise. So we're really excited about all of that.
Question, if I could?
Sure.
Because it's called EdConnects, is it connecting to the iPads? Is that part of the...
They can access it on the iPad. It's online.
Yep, okay.
So they'll be getting those access codes actually in the next week. So they'll be able to play with it a little bit before they come in and get some real training, which will be nice.
Good.
Yeah. And the third item I just wanted to have you take a look at. In your packet, there's a listing of college and universities where our seniors have been accepted. There are almost 100 listed here. We'll have a full program full of them at graduation. I think if you look through these, you can say, I'm really, really proud of our students. This is awesome. Going to many different and impressive places.
Very impressive. Mm-hmm. Any comments, questions for Dr. Lozay?
Thank you, as always.
Thank you very much for that detailed report.
Thank you.
And now, everyone's favorite type of business and financial.
The year-to-date budget report, I provided a year-to-date budget report in the packet, and I'd be happy to answer any questions that you have with regard to that one. Okay, seeing you. In addition, I've provided a list of transfer sphere information with the last few of those requiring a motion to approve. So I'd be looking for your approval for that.
I would entertain the motion for the transfers.
I'll make a motion to approve the transfers as requested by the business manager.
Is there a second? Any questions, comments? All in favor?
Aye.
It is a vote.
Thank you. And with today being June 1st, and in recognition of your past practice with regard to closing out the budget year, I'd like to request that you grant Omnibus approval to allow transfers to be made as needed. I, with the support of Ms. Warren and Ms. Lynch in the business office, will continue to work closely with Dr. Brunel to close out the fiscal 2016 budget, and I will notify you, as we the transfers are completed. But in order to do that, I'd like your approval to make the transfers.
I would entertain that motion.
I'll make that motion.
Is there a second?
Second.
Any discussion, comments? Any glitches? Where's Vicki? As far as with the middle school and what's left, what we're withholding with that and closing out this budget, anything like that that we need to worry about? Are we closing out the budget season pretty well?
I think we're going to be in a good place.
Yeah.
We've been really, really monitoring it very closely. The leadership team's been looking at the needs, and I've been working very closely with Dr. Brunel and the executive leadership team, and we've been making great strides. I think we're going to end up in a great place.
Excellent.
I feel like there's no concerns.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Thank you for the report.
Thank you. Well, I have one more. This wasn't on the agenda, but I'd like to make you aware that the school department will begin to benefit from the town's contract for a net metering credit agreement with a solar farm in Rutland. You may recall in May of 2013, I wasn't here, but the town meeting approved town manager Jacobson to enter into a contract for solar credits, at which time the solar farm needed to be established. So just this past week, we were notified that we'll be receiving credits on our national grid bills from the solar farm, which will reduce our national grid electric costs. Since it's relatively new to us, I'll plan to come back and give you more in-depth information in a future meeting, but I think it's definitely a good news story for the Auburn Public Schools.
Wow.
Excellent. Cool. Thank you for
that. Those
our bills. Energy bills keep getting better and better.
They do. We're very fortunate, so thank you.
Any other comments? All right, we move on to personnel.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. With the approval, as you know, we've brought in-house the job coach position. So we've brought a job description for your review. I'll share with you just an update on all of them in case you want to bundle them together. Next, with your approval of a primary media / technology specialist, a job description was created based very much off of the model from Swanson Rhodes, one, the intermediate school, with some minor tweaks to it based on how they'll utilize there. And then finally, the instructional assistant one, we wanted to add, we had been remiss in just adding in the requirements that it does require an individual to be able to move or lift up to 50 pounds on occasion, depending if their needs for changing students and toileting and such. So just to have it be as complete as possible. So it is my recommendation that you approve those.
Shall we bundle those or would you like to take them separately? Some ones okay. Okay, we're going to entertain a motion to approve all three of the presented items.
I'll make that motion.
Do I have a second?
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. It's a vote.
Thank you.
And we do have to go into executive session?
Very briefly, yes.
I will entertain that motion.
I'll make a motion to authorize the chair. No, what's that?
That was they fooled you.
They fooled me. I'll have to do it from memory. I'll make a motion.
No,
I'll make a motion to go to executive session as per Mass. Chapter 30, Section 21A2 to conduct strategies for negotiations with union and non-union personnel.
Do I have a second?
Second.
Any discussion? Roll call vote.
Yes.
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 Yes. Good night, everyone.